The components are the reflectors, UHF dipole, VHF dipole and Allen, the director clips, the antenna bracket, coaxial cable, power supply, and the power supply unit, also an antenna mount. We begin by assembling the reflector. You'll see at one end there's a second hole, the other end is not, that's the top. We have here two clips, one goes in the top, one in the bottom. Next we can install the director clips. Take the director and open it out. Slightly tighten the wing nut to stop it folding. The top is indicated up. The top is also the same place that the director, the VHF director goes. Assemble the VHF director, a VHF dipole I should say. This is installed at the top. On the outside. Apply the washer. Cable comes through, screws onto the ballon, screw it all the way down. And put the waterproof cover in place. Take the mount. And here there's two small indents. Attach, sorry. Now we also have the mount. It can be mounted on a wall, on a roof. Very simple to install. It has two holes. The lower one goes for the middle, the upper one is the adjustable pivot. Now you will need a spanner, which is not supplied, in order to tighten these. And that can be adjusted to any position you need and can be mounted accordingly. Switch the oven on. Installed your mount, the antenna can be placed on the mount. Take your coaxial cable. One end has a boot on it to seal out the water. This will be attached on here. Do it up firmly and put the waterproof boot in place. Here we have the power supply. Power supply adapter. This end is marked antenna. Connect your antenna to here. The unit is also provided with an F-type joiner in case you need to get a longer cable and join it. This end feeds your TV. Plug in the power supply. We have a red light here, it means this end is working. We also have a red light here on the antenna, this means this is also working. If the red light on the antenna is not on, it means you need to check your cabling. Thank you.